Now, usually my highlights reel is my best shots of the whole round, all 18 holes. This highlights reel is gonna be on my first 5 holes. Hope you enjoy.
I'm not sure if the microphone was working on that last, on Karl's opening tee shot, so I apologise if it wasn't. So he's dropped his 7-iron in the middle of the fairway, just a 3/4 sandwich. Oh, that's a nice start. See how close that pin is to the front of the green. Probably needed to be one club further back just to try and get the ball to stop. Now, this is why players don't go for the screen. It's just completely surrounded by water, and if the ball comes up short, you're hitting off very thick grass here, and this is far too, the risks outweigh the benefits. Good start. Very good. So that was a good putt because Karl stuck to his guns and kept it inside the right lip. So 11th hole, Karl's second for the day. Opened with a birdie. He'll be using 3-wood off the tee here. Yesterday he hit what we thought was a good approach shot here and it spun completely off the green. So today he'll be throwing this ball. As long as he hits a fairway off the tee, he'll be throwing his approach shot past the pin. Seems happy with that. Straight up the middle. Now Karl split the middle with his tee shot with his 3-wood. He would have learnt yesterday that he's got to throw this ball all the way to the flag, and with the pin tucked back left, he's going to have to keep it right at the flag. He's not entirely happy with this. Yeah, he was dancing with danger there, being left to the flag, but he's probably got the perfect putt there. Karl's not first time reading this, is 2 to 3 cups of left. Birdie. Now we have the drivable dog leg left, par 4, 12. Karl's going to go for it with his 3-wood. He doesn't have to, but it's just the nature of the beast. It's a guaranteed par if he just hits a 5-iron and leaves himself 100. But I'm perfectly fine at 14 years of age with Karl finding out firsthand what his boundaries are, what his limitations are. If he messes it up, he'll learn from it. He's not playing for cattle stations yet, he's not a pro yet, but he's learning so much. He's the youngest in the field here. It's a men's tournament. Yeah, he's going for it. What's the line like? Sounded like he hit driver, but I hope it was 3-wood. So good tee shot by Karl. He's
was very accurate. I'll be taking the bin out. These bins are metal, not fiberglass, so it will not go in if it hits it.
Yeah, I'd be taking that flag out there. Wouldn't have made any difference if it hit it, it would have just bounced straight back off. That's a birdie start for Karl. 3 under after 3. So Karl's had the dream start. Birdied holes 10, 11 and 12. Par 5 here, if he gets a good drive away. He missed this fairway yesterday and still made birdie. And I'd say he's gone left again today. Right, Karl's in the same spot as he was on this hole yesterday, which is the adjacent fairway. So he's just going to throw this over the trees that are in front of him and leave himself around 100 yards over those trees there, and hopefully down on the fairway here. Yep, so he'll be leaving himself around 100 yards into the green. Right, Karl's recovered to the ideal position here. He's got roughly 110 yards to the flag. You generally put money on him to get inside of 10 feet here. Didn't sound right. Yeah, he got away with it though. It's a lot of spin. It's about 20 feet there. It wasn't his best shot. Sort of glad that he put it to the right side of the flag. If he goes left and he misses to the left, he's down in the water. So Karl for a birdie, officially at least. We'll break right to left as it gets over the ridge between him and the hole. I don't think he started that far enough right. Well, he got it. That's 4 straight birdies to open the round. Wow. His putting's back on, guys. Last weekend at Borondura Cup was just a hiccup. Par 3, 14th. Karl's had the best start he's ever had, ever, in tournament play. Birdied each of his first 4 holes. Just got to be very careful not to get really amped up here and start hitting the ball a bit further. He's got a par 3 here, the pin tuck left, so it actually suits his shot shape. He seems to like it, as he should. Good lord, he's about to go 5 under 3, 5. Now he's got the bit between his teeth. Well, he's rewriting his own record books here. This is a 610 yard uphill par 5, brutal hole. Karl took bogey here yesterday after spinning his third shot back off the green. Pretty much perfect. Yep. He can't get there in 2. It's about another 500 yards to get to the green. Karl's second shot. Par 5. He leaves himself around 90 to 100 yards. All right, Karl's third shot on the par 5. Accessible pin. He spun back off this green yesterday. Sit down. Yeah, safe shot. 15 feet directly under the hole. He just cannot have a downhill putt on this hole. He just takes off like a cut snake. Right, 15 feet for birdie. This will be birdie number 6 if he can make it. Uphill. He's human. He is human. We have confirmation. So it takes par on this one.
Alright, so I hope you enjoyed the video. First time I've ever had 5 straight birdies, let alone started my round with 5 straight birdies. But if you don't want to know what I shot and where I stand in the field, just stop the video within the next 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, shot 70, which is 2 under par, puts me at the moment tied for 29th. Should make the cut unless something crazy happens, but there's only about 6 to 10 players left to come in. So I'd say I'm safe. Pretty happy to make the cut in such a big event, and it just lets. I feel happy about being under par in a tournament so far, and you know, I'm really looking forward to the weekend, so hopefully you guys can see more good golf. I know that I'd be happy with that. So thanks again, and hope you enjoyed.